created so many mysterious things during the time of creation. The water you drink is mysterious. The blood in your body is mysterious. The blood is so mysterious that it has to become the only link between human life and the spirit. The blood is a living liquid dwelling in human body and the blood of animals. So far as the Bible is concerned, the blood has both physical and spiritual qualities. The blood is so mysterious that in the universities, in medical colleges, they really devoted a section for only the study of blood called hematology. The study of blood is called hematology. And in hematology, by my own personal idea, I can divide hematology into two types, which I titled physical hematology and spiritual hematology. If you study hematology very well, you will soon begin to discover that the blood has two varieties. There is that major one, there is that broad one. In that very major one, they were grouped into four groups. In the broad one, you will see eight groups. Now, in the major one, they were grouped into what we call A group, B group, AB group, and O group. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The truth I want to pass out this morning is that whenever blood is being shed, whenever blood is being spilled, whether you want to believe me or not, it's not even important. The body may die, but the blood can never die. Amen?
Amen. Amen.
In spiritual hematology, I can classify spiritual hematology into 10 groups according to the circumstances of the spillage, according to the condition under which the blood was shed. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Number one, I have what I call war group. W-A-R, war group. Or you call it war. These are the blood of the people that was spilled during war. Both the civilians and soldiers who died innocently. The Bible said, I should let you know this morning, that whosoever that happens to be the governor, whosoever that happens to be the president in charge, you knew that you're supposed to keep peace, but you never did. The blood of those people killed will be required of you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We have what I titled the suicide group. In this suicide group, let me sound this warning. Whenever anybody from anywhere, you commit suicide, hear me this morning, don't even forget the date of today. From that suicidal spot, you are going straight to hellfire. Why? You didn't create that life. The life you are using is a borrowed life, not your own. God gave you that life for you to carry out some responsibilities on the planet Earth. There were so many destinies attached to your life for you to make them grow, for you to make them to become something. And now you are running away from your responsibility, even in the army. Falling out of duty, is this an easy offense? You are not, most of them, most of the life attached to you, you may not give them money. Only your advice, don't do this, do this. It's enough for them to grow. And what pleads my heart very well is that the reason why people commit suicide is because of temporary condition, which will soon pass away. And you say, I'm angry. Why should I train that girl all the way from secondary school to university only for him, only for she to pass out and come out with another husband and say she will no longer marry me again? Then you now go and look for a role and hang yourself. To hell with that girl. Is she the only girl? No other girl more beautiful than her in town? Then you want to kill yourself. You are running away from the assignments given to you by the God of all flesh, which from this altar, I can guess rightly that if you commit suicide, all other things that you must have committed will be forgotten. The only question is going to be, when you will jump into the seat of the judgment of the Most High God, he will only ask you, why are you here? Who brought you to this place? So, when you commit suicide, your own personal blood will cry against you. Amen?
Amen.
We have what I titled the spiritual group. We are talking about spiritual hematology. The spiritual group. In this spiritual group, it comprises of all those occultic members, those witches and wizards, whosoever they can call themselves, the worst blood of men. But no matter how you do it, you will pay for the blood that you wasted. We have what I titled the silence group. We have the shouting group. We have the accidental group. When somebody have accidents and die, blood will be spilled. Blood will be shed. We have what I titled the innocent group. Listen to me very carefully this morning. Many of us don't know the secret behind the battle we are fighting. This may be the reason why. Whenever you spilled any blood innocently, in short, let me put it like this. No man will spill another person's blood and go free. No man will spill another person's blood and go free. That takes us straight away to the book of Genesis chapter 4. Let us read from 9. Then the Lord said to Cain, "Where is Abel, your brother?" It's a question. And he said, "I don't know." He told a lie. "Am I my brother's keeper?" He thought God was his mate. And the Lord asked a question. What have you just done? Look into your Bible. What have you just done? In other words, do you know the implication of your sin? In other words, do you really know that you may not be free from this bondage? In other words, do you know the punishment behind your action? The Lord said, "The blood of your brother cried out to me from where?" Look into your Bible. From the ground. Then notice, Abel that was dead, his blood did not die. Abel that was dead, his blood refused to die. His blood was shouting to the Most High God, "Until when shall you come and avenge of my blood?" It was having a disturbing sound. It was having a kind of, "I can never let you go until you avenge for me." Whenever blood is being spilled, whosoever that is behind the spillage of that blood must pay. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Can we quickly move to the book of Revelation chapter 6 from verse 9 and 10.
Then the Lamb broke open the fifth seal. I saw underneath the altar the soul of those who have been killed because they had proclaimed God's word and had been faithful in their witnessing. 10. They shouted in a loud voice, "Almighty Lord, holy and true, how long will it be until you judge the people on earth and punish them for killing us?"
Very good. Thank you very much. How long, O Lord? In other words, these people that killed us, we can never forgive them. This is an angry blood crying from the grave, crying from the dead. How long, mighty Jehovah, shall you come and avenge of our blood? Now we have read the book of about Cain. We are now talking about the saints now. Their blood is not talking about mercy for anybody. Their blood is not talking about peace for anybody. The only language that the blood understands is the language of judgment. The only language that the blood understands is the language of justice. The blood itself has a direct phone number to God Almighty. It has a hotline to the Lord. It takes no permission from anybody before calling the Most High God. When you look at this, you will begin to discover that a man may not be intelligent while he was on earth. A man may not be educated while he was on earth, but if you spill his blood innocently, the blood immediately becomes automatically intelligent, wise, and smart because he knows the right person to report to. Dead body does not go to court, but blood go to court. As we have some specialized courts in Nigeria, we have the High Court of Appeal, Election Tribunal, we have all the traffic courts and all the rest of them. There is a specialized court where the Almighty God will summon everybody who has, by one mistake or the other, tampered with human life. In that court, God is the judge. The Holy Spirit is the lawyer, because before you do whatever you want to do, there must be a conscience that will tell you, don't do this. You now say to hell with you. You now carry on. That is the Spirit of the Most High God talking to you. The Holy Spirit is the lawyer. Jesus Christ is the one pleading for people. You are the accuser. The devil is the accuser. God will say, come and answer. There is a blood crying against you. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So we move quickly to the book of Luke, chapter 11. Let me hear the 49, 50, 51.
For this reason, the wisdom of God said, I will send them prophets and messengers. They will kill some of them and persecute others. 50. So the people of this time will be punished for the murder of all the prophets killed since the creation of the world. 51, the last. Yes. From the murder of Abel to the murder of Zechariah, who was killed between the altar and the holy place. Yes, I tell you, the people of this time will be punished for them all.
The people of what? This time will be punished for them all. See the calculation. The Bible said, from the blood of Abel, who was the first person to be killed, to the blood of Zechariah, who they killed last. My own version said, from the foundation of the world, from the foundation of the earth. See where the problem lies. He said, they shall be required of this generation. This. If you study your Bible very well, when you go to the book of 2 chapter 20, if you read from verse 1 to verse 4, it says, make to yourself no graven image, either in the nature of anything in heaven, anything on earth, anything underneath the earth. Neither shall you bow down for them. That is verse 4. Listen to verse 5. He says, for I am a jealous God, visiting the iniquities of the people upon the third and fourth generation of those who do what, who hate me, who serve idol. How many years is one generation? 100 years. Second generation, third generation, till fourth generation, that's 400 years. Meaning that the punishment is of idolatry is 400 years. But now, let's do a calculation. This version of the Bible where we have just read is not talking about generation. This one says, from the foundation of the earth, the blood of those martyrs will be required of who? This generation. The Bible is talking about over 400 years ago, 4,000 years ago. That means if I may judge by myself, I will tell you that punishment of killing innocent soul is bigger than just that of idolatry. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
In the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
A woman discovered that in the family of her husband, they don't grow beyond 40 years. But in that family, it's very easy to know the next person that will die. Why? Because all of them, they used to have one particular dream. When you just have that dream, your case is closed. They will grow 38, 39, getting to 40, the person will go. What is that dream? The dream is that they will have dream seeing seven persons carrying a coffin. If you just have that dream, forget about your life. You can see somebody at 38 years, 39, is being the oldest or the king or the leader of the family till it goes to the throne of her husband. Her husband was promoted to the leader of the family.
A night came.
Both of them were sleeping on one bed. The man screamed from the dream and came out alive. The wife was asking, "Honey, what's happening? What's happening? Why? What's happening?" The man said, "That dream, I just had that dream." The woman shouted, "Quick dream." He said, "The dream of having seen seven persons, whatever. The woman shouted, "Hey, that dream, oh, that." She dragged her husband to the church. Indian Mike, that night, confirmed Bobby. Both of them got to the church. They woke the pastor. See what happened. The pastor carried out some series of deliverance on them and said, "Go. Mark yourself. That very night that you will get to your 40 years, don't sleep in the house. Come and sleep in the church." Because of fear, even 3 months to the time, the man and the wife don't pack all their load for church. Now for church, then they back. They go up. That particular night came. There was no church service. Nothing was happening in the church. Pastor, not around. The man on his own just was praying. By 10 o'clock in the night, that seven spirit appeared physically, carrying that coffin. All their struggle is to carry this man and put inside the coffin. But according to the testimony of that man, the man said there was a kind of demarcation dividing the spirit and his wife, just like this paraphrase. They were struggling to cross the paraphrase, but they could not. The man was praying, the woman was praying. They all was just battling for almost 2 hours. When it was 12 midnight, 1 minute after 12, the spirit vanished. Why? Because the man had made it to enter his 40 years. I speak to every life here. Who there is something like that in your family, where they do not grow beyond any particular year, where they do not proceed beyond any particular success level, where they do not graduate, where they don't go beyond secondary school. You, that family, hear the word of the Lord. Let that blood crying against you be silenced in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
What is this portion of the Bible trying to tell us? It says, from the foundation of the world, see now, all the people killed will be required of which generation? He didn't say that generation that killed them. He said of this generation. So the Bible is trying to tell us that there could be a modern surface of ancient iniquities. You could be paying your grandfather's bill while you did not buy anything from his generation. Your grandfather can write a promissory note on your behalf. You could be sharing from parental cause of iniquity. Evil chain can bind the whole family. Evil parental causes can lead to many things. Servants will be ruling over them. No access to breakthrough and deliverance. Difficulties in finding good job. Marital cruelty, marital distress, and all kinds of things. Marital general backwardness. Reaping failure when you should have success. Dreaming horrible dreams. All this could be because there is a blood crying against you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now you are here. You say, "What is this man even wasting my time talking about blood? I have not killed anybody." And she is just, "What is this preacher talking about?" Listen to me very carefully. You may not take part in any killing. Because it was done in your lineage. Because it was done in your foundation. Because it was done in your environment. You stand guilty. You know that sin of one person committed in this ground can contaminate the whole of this ground. No matter how holy you may be, you will be suffering from what is happening. Some houses, both in Aba, in Lagos or whatever, you may be a very rich man. As soon as you pack into the house, everything will start scattering. Up to the level that you will even sell your motor, sell everything only to make it. But when you go out of that family, things will start working. That's what we are talking about. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Who are those that are guilty of blood? All unbelievers are guilty of blood. Why? The foundation of Africa was laid in idolatry. Not until the missionary came, they were trying to inculcate the worship of Jesus Christ to Africans, and Africans were still killing them. Even to that, not everybody have accepted Christ. And the Bible said that the blood of Jesus speaks better thing than the blood of Abel. Jesus is the only one who can go back to your past, rewind back to your yesterday, refine every unconscious condition to come and become what you didn't receive the Jesus. And many of us who have even received this very Jesus do not have the knowledge that there is what we call avengers of blood. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Who are those that are guilty of blood? All abortions. If you have committed abortion, the baby you killed could be a prophet of God. There was this doctor in Lagos State University. He used to abort for all these 2 years. When they come, he would say, well, I can do it today. I can equally do it today. And they will say, hey, free. The man will say, if I must do it free, I will first of all sleep with you. Then I do, you go. And practically all the guests used to accept. He has been doing this thing, until he become old. He now fell sick. He was about to die. He struggled for only 3 days with death. He could not die, he could not live. He was only shouting, I'm hearing the sound of babies. I'm hearing the cries of babies. All through till 3 days before he gave up. Those are the sounds, the noises of blood crying against him. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Who are those that are guilty of blood? If you take Holy Communion worldly, here we have communion service. There are some issues you need to settle with God, but you never did. You just come and join up. You see free drink. The Bible says that the blood will be crying against you. Who are those that are guilty of blood? Those pastors who have forgotten everything about salvation. They are always talking about money in the house of God. Now the members die of sin. Their blood, the Bible says that you will pay. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Backsliders are guilty of blood. Witches are guilty of blood. And the truth I want to pass out is that the value of human blood, just like land, it does not diminish. It remains valuable forever. And you say, I don't kill anybody. What is this man really talking about? Listen to me, let me tell you. Are you a contractor? They gave you money, come and build this church. You did your substandard calculation because you needed more profit. You bought some inferior materials. You now gave us a one kind bad construction in this place. And the church has collapsed, killed so many people. Unto every soul that dies in that place. The Bible says that it will be required of you. If you have anybody in government, warn them. Governors, presidents, local government chairman, they gave them the allocation for them to do road, but they never did. At times, they will just do some substandard calculation. They will embezzle the money. They will submit a badly planned road. The road, within 2 months, it has started disturbing again. Accidents are happening there every day. People are dying day in, day out. Newspaper are carrying the television and radio. The Bible says that I should tell you, unto every soul that dies in that road where you embezzle the money, you will certainly pay for their blood. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Are you a mechanic? Somebody gave you money to repair. You say, go and come. I'm busy. Just go. Just go and come. Before the man comes back, you don't lose the pass. You carry bleeds. You blow, you put back. You now call the man and say, oh, guy, it don't good. The man carry money, pay you. He drive the motor, come off for road, go get accident, die. The Bible says that their blood will be required on your head. Are you an army commander? Are you a clerk? Are you an ugly couple? Because somebody offended you, they now say, bring one person, we are going for attack. You never produce this very guy because they still bring one person. You produce him because they demanded that they are going for attack. If they are going to UN, you could have said he is not available. You produce that very person who offended you. If he dies in that attack, the Bible says, you, your family, your children to come, they will certainly pay for their blood. You were involved in raping a virgin. Whether she dies or she is alive, you spilled her blood. The Bible says that you are responsible for the blood of that very virgin. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah!
Are you a lawyer or judge? You are ready to let the guilty go free and you jail an innocent man. He dies in that jail. The Bible says that you can never fail to pay of the blood of him. Many people who can say, I never killed anybody, you may be so much surprised that people will queue up and God will say you are responsible. That's why I'm feeling so much guilty. I'm just feeling so genuinely sorry for our country, Nigeria. The blood that our forefathers have wasted is still fighting us. The one that some families did is still fighting their children. And now we are doing another one again. Look at bombing every day. Look at kidnapping every day. Every day people are dying. I really don't know how this country will look like in the next 20, 30, 40, 50 to 200 years to come. Because the country is in trouble. Why? The blood must be avenged. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
This is a very big message, and I don't know if I should continue. We cannot make it because of our time. Right now, you are going to stand on your feet and begin to ask God that, is there any blood that is crying against you? Whatever sin that your parents must have committed, including your own personal sin, that may God, by His infinite mercy, wash you clean. May God wash you clean. May God wash you clean. Forgive you all the sins of the Father. Forgive you all the sins of the ancestors. May He wash you clean this morning. Open your mouth and fire prayer.
Continue to pray to unto God. God has spoken to your mind this morning. He has spoken to your spirit man. As the purpose why this message is being drawn for us this morning. Bible says the word will not come back to him in vain. He will surely accomplish that which he has sent for. So get up on your mind this morning and begin to talk to God. Whatever blood that is on your head, whatever blood that is crying, calling your name, that you don't know anything about it. You are innocent of it. Ask God for forgiveness this morning. Ask God for forgiveness this morning. Ask God for forgiveness this morning. Open your mouth and pray in that direction. Oh, yes, Lord, Father. Remember to understand through your word this morning, Lord. That you will possess all of any fraud. Hey, that was changed. Even out of one generation. Oh, from the beginning of the world. Lord, I pray this morning, Lord, Father, by the fortune of the birth of this morning, Lord, Father, may we have a sin, Lord. May we have a persecution, Lord, my Father, may we have protect us in sharing of blood, Lord. Father, I pray, may we be forgiven in the mighty name of Jesus. May we be forgiven in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, from any around. Shall we say this for us together?
Draw me nearer.
Jesus every day. Voilà.
My soul.